Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So in this video, I want to showcase a max limit break level 85 Yuri. Okay, once again, this is not my account, this is Gumi's account. And Gumi basically lent me this account so that I can make the review video for Yuri. Okay, so the swimsuit skin. Alright, of course, it is much cuter. Wow, very cute. The original skin, well, it is also cute actually, but okay, I prefer the one with swimsuit. Okay, so if it's without any gear, this is her stats. Agility 140 for a blade master is actually very high. It is actually because of the job machinist. We can use booster plus shoe to raise the agility. So as a blade master, her agility is still very very high even with this skill that lowers agility. So if it's compared to Sakura, Yuri is kind of faster. I mean, the agility is faster, but Sakura is winning with higher max HP and higher P attack from the warrior passive ability. Meanwhile, if it's compared to Setsuna, Setsuna has the move 1 jump 1, the one from Assassin, basically Shadow Assassin. So Setsuna has move 5, but this one only have move 4. Actually, you can give her ninja stealth, which makes her just like Setsuna, basically. Yeah, well, Sakura can also do the same actually with the ninja stealth, but the unique one about Yuri compared to the other blade masters like Sakura and Setsuna is this booster plus 2, which means her agility is the highest compared to Setsuna and Sakura. Okay, the B attack is still very decent even without any gear. If it's with her own gear, the P attack is actually very decent, 691, and the max HP without any gear, 1200, which is actually quite decent. If it's with the Wanderer's head, it is 1412. Okay, it is decent, of course. And if it's with Alchemono, 1572. Personally, I prefer this one for higher initial jewel. And lastly, if it's with agility plus 10 gear, her agility is 152. This is actually very very high for a blade master, and this is her special thing. Alright, the PDEF is okay, not bad, not too low, not too high, and the magic defense is quite low. Dexterity quite okay, 400 something, it's a little bit high. Okay, so for the passive build, either booster plus 2 or ninja stealth. Or you can also tune up plus 2 to raise the dex so that she can get better hit rate. Also, it will increase the attack with higher dex. As you can see here, attack increases according to agility and dex. So for the best damage, regal girl with a blade and tune up plus 2 for her. But you can also use this booster plus 2 for better agility, so up to you. But in this video, I will try to showcase her damage using this setup. And let's see, with Wanderer's head, can we use her master ability right from the beginning? Yeah, 3 hits thunder slash damage to single target and greatly raises on PDEF, MDEF until next turn, range 1. So anyway, let's try to showcase her damage. And her leader skill raises speed attack by 40% and jewel obtained by 5 for thunder units. Not something that is super OP, but P attack plus 40 is actually quite decent, even though it is not the highest. The highest one is P attack plus 50% owned by Monzain. Her damage should be very good because of the leader skill also boosts P attack. So we can expect some nice damage from her. As for the basic ability, I still recommend to use the basic swordsman, the one from the blade master, because you can get the P attack boost from the basic ability. So starting MP 64, and you can use the master ability not right from the beginning. Yeah, you cannot use the master ability right from the beginning because it costs 70 jewel. Wow, so expensive. Well, you can use Sinister's Gaze, but obviously this is not for her because Sinister's Gaze is for magic attackers. Let's see the damage. If it's to water enemy, 1429. Yeah, because she has thunder element, so that's why. If it's to thunder element, 1053 damage. So still a very good damage in my opinion. Omniblast raises slash attack of ally units with an area around self for 3 turns, including the max HP. So let's see the damage boost. From 1053. Okay. Around 15% damage increased. The P attack boost is from the leader skill, by the way. The one that got boosted just now is a slash attack. So around 15% slash attack boost. Not really that significant to this water enemy. Okay. So just like the other blade masters, basically Tiger Tremor is the one that we want to use from her because it is the AoE 5/5 diamonds from her and it is quite painful. And the most damaging skill is Razor's Determination. And if you want to boost her damage, use this skill, Darkness Illumination, and you will get higher damage after that. Okay, now the normal attack damage is 1824. So, decent boost for the damage. And the Razor's Determination is now 2932, and the Tiger Tremor's damage 2470. And basically, this is her best damage, other than the master ability. Okay, now the master ability's damage. Wow, insane. Okay, this is not even with the P attack boost. So 4593, right? So let's try this, Darkness Illumination, and then let's try to use the Master Ability after that. Now, 5274 damage. This is insane. Let's try it. Wow, just so wow. The master ability's damage is very high, very very high, but it is only one range. If only it is a long distance attack, and if only it is AoE attack, then she could be a very very dangerous unit to use. But too bad, even with the Wanderer's head, we cannot use her master ability right from the beginning. So yeah, she is just like a thunder elemental Setsuna without charge up. Yeah, maybe more like the thunder elemental Sakura to be exact. Alright, but yeah, I think she is a good addition for the thunder elemental units. Because of, if you don't have Gilgamesh, then I think she is going to be good for you to use as your thunder damage dealer with range 4 diamond 5 AoE Tiger Tremor. Wow, okay. But as for me, I think in my real account, I might going to skip this banner, sadly. Yeah, because I think it is also okay if I don't have her. She is good, but she is optional. Blade Master is a very good job, but I think to have her in the game, especially if you already have Gilgamesh, it's kinda optional. If you are trying to use her in arena, personally, it will be situationally good because there are so many players using powerful wind characters such as Rider Yomi, Bulk, Ignis, Seida, Setsuna, and the other wind characters. So thunder characters may be other than Gilgamesh, because Gilgamesh is still very good, even versus wind elemental characters, because he still can use basic magic blade. But this one, she doesn't have elemental attacks. All of her attacks are neutral damage, so she won't be able to do very high damage, even to water enemy. If only her skills is thunder element, she will be able to do higher damage to water enemy actually, but alright, yeah. I think she's just kinda average overall. She's pretty good to use, very fast, but I think it is also very okay if you don't have her. If you have her and it's happened that you don't have any Gilgamesh, you can try to raise this one as your Thunder DPS. Yeah, I think she could do the job pretty well as a Blade Master. The fast Blade Master, by the way, with Booster. 150 to agility as a Blade Master is actually very high. If it's without the regular Garuda Blade, 165 agility. Wow, a Blade Master, guys. Alright, so I think that's all for now. That's what I think about Yuri. Well, obviously, she is very cute. So, yep, thank you for watching. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe now if you haven't. And see you again next time. Bye-bye. The Alchemist Code Global Punch.